ما شاء الله عليكم.
صحيح. Which is good. We're gonna finish today the chapter of pregnancy and lactation. Also, these two chapters are the longest chapters because they set the foundation. From now on, everything else will be cool technically. Now. The one part, last time I found out that I didn't upload the lecture, was about labor and postpartum. So a pregnancy does not end by giving birth. There are also postpartum issues that happen to women after they give birth. And some of these issues are quite common and quite serious.
After complete cervical dilation and delivery, actually, for the baby,
skeletal muscles. So it is a between a visceral pain and somatic pain. Of course, we have non-pharmacological approaches that could go hand in hand with pharmacological approaches. Usually women become chatting, well, oh, I don't want pain medication. I want to feel the labor, I want to, you know, then basically she'll allow me to know, now I want medication. Sometimes it's too late, okay? Just so you know, if it's too late, you have to suffer. So emotional support definitely helps in any pain, but especially here, okay? It was found, you know, أقل relative vaginal deliveries, أقل cesarean, أقل requests for pain medication women who have emotional support. Warm water baths, they help, they make temporary, and some women decide to give birth completely in a water bath, okay? They reason, you know, the baby was surrounded by water and you suddenly bring him out surrounded by this air. It's better if he comes out surrounded by water. It does not decrease assisted deliveries or cesarean section, but some of them they benefit. Acupuncture tends other ways of decreasing pain in general. The rasna has in pain management also could be tried. Now, pharmacological approaches, which is what we are involved, or you know, we're going to talk more about. When do we give the woman analgesia or pain medication? When she requests. There is no like medical, or there has to be a medical reason. The medical reason is the maternal request, okay? But as I said, sometimes if she's beyond certain stage, they cannot give her certain types of analgesia. So they usually will tell the woman that now is the time to get epidural if you want epidural. If you don't get epidural now and you decide later, you're not going to be able to get epidural, okay? But maternal request is sufficient. Yeah, because you sit there and I did analgesia, okay? So we have two types. اللي حكيت عنه الابيديورال والبارنتال، اوكي؟ هلا الابيديورال هو اللي تسمعوا فيها اكثر شيء، رايت؟ ابيديورال، ابي مينز يعني ما فوق، اوكي؟ سو اوتسايد ذا ديورا. It does not usually affect the functions, so the woman can still, just without pain, but she can still feel the contractions and she can still push. And that's why it is يعني the preferred method. But it could lead to prolongation of the first and second stages of labor, okay? Because if the mother does not feel the pain, she might not be inclined. But it's often in the usually what is given here are local anesthetics, okay? To numb the nerves. So when they numb the nerves, they numb everything, including the nerves that go to the muscles. From certain prolongation, then stages of labor, okay? They found, you know, the higher number of instrumental deliveries when they have to use instruments, like the fork that they grab the baby to bring him out if he's not coming out, okay? So there is increase, again, because this will make the woman less responsive, so she might need help. I'll have the cesarean sections, all because of fetal distress and maternal fever. Now, the main complication of epidural anesthesia is there might be a puncture of the subarachnoid space that leads to severe headache. That is the most important adverse effect. It's not scary, it's not lethal, but it is painful and it is annoying, okay? And this is because of the procedure itself, which is because of the anesthesia or the pain medication, it's the procedure. Parenteral abuse, it would be given parenteral. Usually, if we give it, we get lower rate of oxytocin augmentation, shorter stages of labor, fewer instrumental deliveries and cesarean when we do the parenteral, okay? Well, I think we're not as effective as spinal or epidural analgesia, okay? So here it is, the epidural, they are not on top of the dura. Outside, that's the individual space between, should be between L3 and L4, spine, the vertebrae, and on top. So the solution that they introduce, which is usually local anesthetic, will just bathe the area outside. So it's not gonna reach, it should not reach the brain, okay? All the spinal cord above the area of the lumbar spine. But that's when puncture happens because of the, and this is not an OB-GYN who give it, it usually should be anesthesiologist, نفس الطبيب التخدير. But sometimes they have a problem and they puncture. If they puncture, then it can reach. And it causes this rare effect, which is weird side effects in who work it. The spinal, or not the spinal mark, if you will, the spinal light was inside and it bathed the spine. Okay? Usually, a spinal anesthesia is given if they want to do cesarean section. Because it's given at higher level, it numbs the area all the way down while the patient is awake. Okay? Now, epidural, as we say, the major or the rare but it's severe side effect is this headache, severe headache because of the puncture. It might cause maternal hypotension, shivering, the bladder function compromised, which usually delivery often compromises bladder and bowel functions. Restricted movement, because when they put the epidural for her, she cannot move. The needle is there and she should not move. And it might go on label. Now, the baby comes out. Delivery is not done until we deliver the placenta. The most severe and responsible for maternal morbidity and mortality is the problem with the placenta, not delivered to it. Okay? The placenta stays inside? No. The placenta has to come out. The placenta, part of it come out and part of it stay also is a big problem. Okay? So we end up with this very serious adverse effect in the whole postpartum hemorrhage. So the third stage label is placental delivery, which is the first stage. Second stage, this is the third stage. It's an emergency, this hemorrhage, morbidity and mortality. And we define it by loss of 500 ml of blood within 24 hours of vaginal delivery or 1,000 ml after cesarean. Then even after cesarean, the placenta has to come out, okay? Now, what are the risk factors? Many. Like retained placenta, as I said, if the placenta does not get delivered, or failure to pull this during the second stage labor. The woman finished second stage, the baby delivered, but pull this to the third stage does not happen. There is also these cases, we call them placenta aplasia, okay, where the placenta is low in the uterus. I don't know if you can see it. Placenta should be here. If it's here, that's a placenta previa, okay? Decamant, the placenta, excreta, but the placenta is not in the right position, okay? These are different types of placental positions that are not very ideal. Placenta excreta, placenta excreta, or placenta previa, okay? Lacerations, okay? In the placenta, in the uterus, instrument they delivery, when they have to use instrument, they might puncture, okay, and cause hemorrhage. And large from gestational age newborn, when the baby comes out large, this might cause also hemorrhage. And that's why we don't wait. If the woman is 42 weeks, we have to deliver. If not vaginal, then we have to deliver by cesarean section. Hypertensive disorder is labor induction, augmentation of labor with oxytocin, prior history, maternal obesity, and preeclampsia. All these are risk factors for postpartum hemorrhage, which is an emergency that we have to deal with. They have to deal with it immediately. يحس. إذا we first have to exclude in a few parts of the placenta stayed inside. So exclusion of uterine products of conception and cervical and vaginal lacerations. After we excluded, we look at another cause, which is what we call uterine atony. Atony. What is uterine atony? Tonicity is the ability of the muscle to contract, right? Atonic, it loses this ability. When it loses this ability, it becomes atonic. Fernando, it stops being able to push, okay? And here we can give oxytocin, okay? To help with pushing of the placenta. CNN, uterotic medications, intramuscular oxytocin method, or ibuprofen, or combination of these medications to enhance the tonicity of the uterus, and the uterus have to contract to push whatever left from the placenta, or كل placenta, or fragment of the placenta. Labor and delivery, we consider preterm labor if the woman delivers between 20 and 37 weeks of gestation. حكينا 20 weeks, the baby is viable. The fetus is viable, which means it can survive outside the womb. It can, not necessarily. The prematurity is the number one killer of fetus, of children and born around the world, okay? Many are dying because of prematurity. Up to 37 weeks, لأن 38 weeks and above, 38 to 42 is considered a term baby. Now, of course, the more weeks, the better. If you can miss, you know, the واحد انولد 7 months, بعيش 8 months, صحيح؟ Every week, advancement in labor is even better than the week before. There is no such thing, okay? It's the leading cause of infant morbidity and mortality. Risk factors and equal previous preterm. And the woman always have preterm infections, multiple gestations, which she have a twin, or multiple hassle, بيعملوا IVF, usually they get pregnant with 2 or 3 babies, poverty, non-white race, maternal complication factors like smoking, use of the uterine function and causes, incompetent cervix, previous pregnancy with adverse outcomes. All these are risk factors for preterm labor. There is no test. We cannot test the same high woman that had less term or preterm. There is this protein, 5-1-10, fetal 5-1-10, it's a lack of protein, like the cervix or vaginal secretions. Usually, we met its measure of and the baby is يعني, coming out. فإذا لقينا ahead of time, that means the baby is ready to come out every day. Okay? Cervical shortening. The cervix is a long, okay? And that's the difference between the cervix and the vagina. These are two different things. The vagina is the outside part of the woman's reproductive system, where the cervix is that long tube, okay, that between the vagina and the uterus, okay? Sometimes it is not that long. So shortening of the cervix could lead to preterm labor. And the only thing that can be done if we are not ready to deliver the baby is to put the woman on a bed rest and keep her hydrated. So after I show other therapies. So the woman has to deliver, colors, okay? If she went into labor, the baby, the fetus has to come out. But there are things that we can do to prolong or to postpone, but usually not more than 1 week. Reasons for postpone, مثلاً, are to mature the lungs of the baby. Remember, the ductus arteriolus only closes near time, near delivery, okay? And if the baby is born suddenly with the ductus arteriolus still not closed, okay, they cannot breathe, they will die of asphyxiation. So we need time to give them medication to the woman to reach her fetus in order for this to happen. Also sometimes maybe she lives far away and the hospital or the medical center near her is not that equipped and we need to transfer her to a better hospital. So we need this time. So we use what we call to politic therapy, ولك علينا احنا الفارما, right? They postpone delivery to allow antenatal corticosteroid administration or transportation of the mother. It prolongs when there is underlying systemic conditions, okay? مثلا pyelonephritis, abdominal surgery that we have to be done. Not utilized beyond 34 weeks of gestation, okay? In the 34 weeks of gestation, there is no need. So this is if it's between 20 and 34 weeks. What do we give? It الفارما هو البيتا أجونست. The uterus becomes very rich with beta receptors. Which ones? Beta 1 or beta 2?
2.
Beta 2, that's all. So beta 2 agonist relax, right? And the beta 1 actually relax. So they relax the uterus, they relax the smooth muscles of the uterus, and cause the prolongation, the cell relaxation, acts of contraction. So we have the contraction of the liquid. Magnesium can be used, calcium channel blockers can be used, prostaglandin inhibitors like NSAIDs can be used, and these will serve two functions. They will prolong, and they also close the ductus arteriolus. Exactly. Usually, they will postpone the quality agents between 48 hours to 1 week. As I said, not more than 1 week. Cannot postpone it more than that. Hello. Antibiotics and anti-infection. Okay? Not routinely to be used, but we use it in the feeder. We can premature rupture of the membranes. هذا اللي راح يتلقوا المستشفى يطلع لك تدريب نسائي راح يشوفوا كثير. BB gone. Okay? This happens before 34 weeks. Okay? In this case, we have to give them a prophylactic antibiotics. اللي هو لما بيحكوا نزلت مية الراس. ليش نزلت مية الراس؟ لأن صار في puncture of the membrane. The baby is inside the uterus, but he or she are inside a membrane. Sometimes they are born with the whole membrane on, okay? There is nothing about it. It just happens, okay? So the baby comes out with this. But this, if it punctures before delivery, usually it should puncture so the baby can be delivered. But it's punctured early on, In this case, we have to give, among other medications, we give her more medication than this. We give her antibiotics. 7-day course of antibiotics, monoclonal ampicillin plus erythromycin, followed by amoxicillin and erythromycin base. Our amoxicillin, that we don't give amoxicillin plug urinate actually. It is not recommended, and it was found to cause this side effect, necrotizing into colitis. Okay? So we don't recommend it. We just give ampicillin as such, mild erythromycin to account for pathogen that might be not responsive to this antibiotic. We give also progesterone, late. It will diminish the cervical lining, softening of the cervix, necessary for cervical dilation before birth. It will decrease it. And our minimal age was born, okay, to prevent preterm labor. So we are training them that will postpone. Among it, progesterone. Reduce uterine wall contractility and it will modulate inflammation. So it will prevent spontaneous preterm birth. You might hear of women, once they are found to be pregnant because they have a problem, they put them on progesterone for the whole time. Okay? You will see that. نستعمل ايش؟ Intramuscular 17 alpha hydroxyprogesterone weekly, 250 milligrams, or as vaginal suppository 100 milligrams. Then the week 16 and 24, continue to wait 37 women. They decide to have mishkili before, because if it happened before, there is higher possibility it will happen again. Antenatal corticosteroids are different, okay? So horn antenatal corticosteroids for what? To postpone the labor. Now we're going to give for corticosteroids for what? For maturation of the lungs for the baby. And now the safety lung maturation is approved by the Cochrane reviews with American College of obstetric and gynecology. Now, the dexamethasone, both milligram intramuscularly every 24 hours for two doses, or dexamethasone 6 milligram intramuscularly every 12 hours for four doses. Okay? So, the same amount, okay? Either 12 for two doses or 6 for four doses. Another infection that is serious, okay, for women pregnant, and we have to deal with it before delivery, and it can transfer to the baby, is the group B streptococcus infection, okay? Because this is associated with invasive disease in the newborn, the newborn for sure, okay? Which increases the risk for pregnancy loss, premature delivery, transmission of the bacteria to the infant during delivery. Okay? Usually, actually, sensitive pregnant women are colonized with this bacteria. So, group B streptococcus infection is serious, but we have to treat it before it reaches the infant. Okay? It's recommended normal universal screening. Nachod vaginal or rectal culture in أسابيع 35 to 37 before الولادة عشان نتأكد okay عشان إذا موجود نلحق نعطيها الأدوية الليبل and no screening information is available لو فضيحة الليبل يعني ولدت تتولد we didn't find أي proof إنها عملت screening عملوها screening so we don't know إذا أنت ولا ما عندنا شو نعطي we give antibiotics إذا كان عندها في فيبر أعلى من 100 فهرنهايت اللي هو 38 سلسيوس أو إذا صار عندها مينغويل رابتشر in the last 18 hours أو إذا كانت أقل من 37 so نبدأ بغض النظر إذا ما فيش عاملين لها سكرين إذا عاملين سكرينينج of course and it is positive we have to treat if it's negative there is no need for treatment what are the treatment? It's really easy it really group based with producers because even penicillin G can be given IV two and a half million units every 4 hours and the delivery of the ampicillin, IV. إذا عندها ampicillin allergy, if not this is azolin. إذا عندها high risk, not be clindamycin, okay? إذا resistant, if not the azithromycin, vancomycin. يعني ندرج عادة الانتيبيوتكس in general. Cervical labeling and label induction. Sometimes the woman is about time, she should give labels, but it's not happening. The cervix is not ripening, stop, okay? Cervix have to ripen. It thins out and it shortens. The thinner. The muscles around it become thinner, okay? So that it can allow for the delivery, for the passage of the baby, okay, of the baby. So, last few weeks of pregnancy, cervix should soften and tense. Mediated by hormonal changes. بما في البروستاجلاندين ثم بالذات البروستاجلاندين هم مسؤولين عن العملية A2 والF2A بزيدوا الكولاجينيز اكتيفيتي فالكولاجين الموجود ببلش يتحلل ففي عندي هاي سوفتنينج والثينينج اوكي leading to thinning eye dilation postdartium اذا كانت الست اكثر من 42 ويك نسميها postdartism واذا البريجنسي induced hypertension and we have to deliver we have to induce إحنا thinning and ripening of the cells. على infant indication نعمل label induction إذا عندها placenta previa أو إن placenta مش محلها صح أو البلفيك structure شكله مختلف. Some women have pelvic have uterus shape that is not favorable for normal vaginal delivery. Okay. Doesn't mean she's gonna get pregnant. She can, but then we have to deliver by cesarean section. Oblique or transverse pelvic section abnormally prolonged umbilical cord, bullet umbilical cord. We do like in the lab of the jugua and active pelvis is that. So your bullet, طالع لبولا. The umbilical cord pelvic baby طالع. Okay, that's bullet. See, and that's called system. Some of the bishop's cord system. Have at least 5 millimeters. It's cervical dilation with cervical effacement or thinning. So we have cervical effacement. The station of the baby hit when? When the baby hit, but surely I feel that it means that it's tight. Okay, when ready for delivery, then we all know they come hit first. Consistency of the cervix and position of the cervix. هذول الكريتيريا الآن سكول and based on the scoring we can decide if the system تحتاج نيرفال اندكشن أو لا. Less than 6 indicate the need for cervical ripening while أكثر من 8 ما في داعي, معناته she can deliver vaginally with no problem. So they measure these and then they score them and based on them they decide إنه إحنا نعمل نيرفال اندكشن أو it's good. Induction by non-pharmacological methods and the castor oil, hot bath, even sexual intercourse and liver stimulation, because all these can stimulate oxytocin, okay? And oxytocin is a natural labor inducer, يعني contraction شديدة, okay? Foley catheter based in non-pharmacological service for buying has been found to be as effective as prostaglandin A2. ممكن نعمل prostaglandin A2. Membrane stripping is safe and inexpensive. You know, they put something to strip the outside. Anything to induce this label, okay? Foley catheter, a catheter that's not real, it's not connected to anything. In the uterus, in the cervix, to induce this label. All these are non-pharmacological. If they work, don't work, we have pharmacological agents. We have prostaglandin E2 analogs, dipropostol. اللي هو mostly commonly used, موجود as gel, موجود as vaginal insert, okay. الاسم التجاري Vimidil 500 microgram administered intracervically in the cervix. Dose may be repeated after 6 hours, that 3 doses for 24 hours, okay. The patient remains to bind for 30 minutes and doesn't have to admit it, okay. Contain 10 milligram dinoprostol with a slower more constant release of medication than the gel had and the inefficient gel. It has an insert. Removed when labor begins after 12 hours. Okay, but when the labor starts, we can remove it. طبعا ميزوبرستول اللي اصلا ممنوع عشان بعمل ابورشن بس هون لانه راح يعمل كونتراكشن يساعد في الدليفري سو وي كان يوز ات. هو عباره كذا كوبروستاجلاندين اي 1 انالوج افكتيف موجود بشكل انترفيجنال ادمستيشن از تابلتس given at least 3 to 6 hours في اورال also. Most commonly found as side effects are uterine hyperstimulation and meconium stain amenorrhea. تطلع يعني الامينتيكولار فلويد مختلف لونه بس كنت انديكيت women with a previous uterine scar لانه ممكن يعني يعمل severe contraction اذا او يعني مثلا women who had cesarean section بتشوفوا دائما خلاص لازم دائما تعمل cesarean section medically doesn't correct. يعني women who have cesarean section should be able to deliver vaginally. بس ليش هو بي؟ لأنه في scar. لأنه الرحم في scar. Even though it can, there is this fear of rupture. Okay? So these women usually are scar بسبب عملية تانية. We try not to give them this label and use our agent. And that concludes this chapter. Here, خلصنا 2 chapters. I'm gonna check it and turn out in the hospital first exam 30 شهر. حكيت مع الدكتورة نور and she's like فوجدني إنه إجاها من التسجيل إنه خلص mid or final. هلا بروح لعندها because I don't know what happened. Why is it like this? But إذا لسه بـ30 شهر يعني تنسوا حالكم بس يا الله يرحم